Hey Bears, it's Bridget and welcome back to another week of video announcements. We were so overwhelmed with how many of you watched last week's announcements, so thank you for taking the time to watch them. I hope you've been enjoying the nice weather we've been having while social distancing and keeping up with your online classes. Remember that your teachers should be posting assignments at 9 a.m. on their assigned day on Google Classroom, so make sure to keep checking your emails for that. And I know that online learning can be creating a lot of stress for us, which is why I'm super excited to throw it to Gracie to hear her top 5 ways on how to relieve stress. Let's hear it, Gracie.
Hey Bears, it's Gracie. I know there's been a lot of change, whether it's globally, nationwide, statewide, or even in our own school of Tahoma, where we're moving on to online school. Now, with change also comes stress and maybe some anxiety, so that's why I will bring to you the top 5 ways to reduce stress and take a mental break. Let's get started. Coming in at number 5 is imagery meditation. Basically, what imagery meditation is you sit down or you can lie down, whatever you prefer, and you imagine yourself in a peaceful scene, like walking across a beach or camping in a rainforest, whatever you really like. This can be done by following a YouTube video where they guide you through it, or you can just do it on your own and imagine yourself in a place that you love. That's it. Okay, so I forgot to add this. The reason I put this as number 5 is because personally, I've never tried it, but from the research I've done, it sounds pretty relaxing and like a good mental break, so that's why I put it in here. Coming in at number 4, we have exercise. Exercise is a great way to put all your thoughts away and solely focus on one thing, but say exercise isn't really your thing, you don't really like high interval training, what you can do is you can take a walk or a bike ride to make it more of a relaxing activity for you. All right, next. Coming in at number 3, we have listening to music. Personally, this is my favorite just because there's something about taking your own time to just relax and listen to your favorite artists. I really like it, definitely recommend this one. Okay, next. Coming in at number 2, we have writing down at least 5 things you're thankful for. As humans, it's really easy for us to just focus on all the bad things and the negative things that are going around, and we just miss all the good things that are happening in our life. Like, especially right now with all the bad media and the coronavirus and everything just going in our mind. It's really easy for us just to focus on that when there's possibly tons of good things that are happening around us that we aren't even realizing. So, definitely give that a try. If you can write more than 5, do so. If you can only think of 5, just write down 5 and come back later. Okay, coming in at number 1, we have doing artwork. Now, this can be painting, doodling, drawing, coloring. It's really easy just to put away all the negative thoughts and just solely focus on creating art. And it's really fun, and I definitely recommend to give this a try. Okay, side note, coloring can actually have a meditative effect, and a study found that when people are coloring in geometric patterns, their anxiety levels actually decrease. So definitely give that one a try. Okay, well that's all I've got for you this week, Bears. I hope you give those 5 a try, or at least one of them. Stay healthy, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye!
Wow, I really enjoyed that, Gracie, so thank you. I'll be sure to try out some of those tips when I'm feeling stressed or overwhelmed. Remember, Bears, it's okay to take a mental break every once in a while. And speaking of taking a mental break, we have a super exciting event going on this Friday. So let's throw it to future me to hear what it's all about.
Hey Bears, do you or someone you know love yoga or just want to take a breather? Well, here's your chance. Our very own Miss Flynn will be hosting a live yoga session this Friday at 9 a.m. Many of you, including myself, attended the last yoga session and it was so much fun. So if you would like to attend the yoga session this week, all you have to do is go onto a mobile phone, laptop, or computer, go to the Tahoma High School Facebook page and click like. That way the video will show up right on your feed. Remember, this is beginner friendly and accessible to all. And if we can't be together, we might as well breathe together. So remember, Bears, grab your mat, grab a family member if you want, and come to the live yoga session at 9 a.m. this Friday, April 24th.
Wow, I'm so excited to attend the yoga session this Friday. I hope to see you all there. On another note, you guys seem to love seeing old faces from last year, Weatherman Zach, so I decided to bring back the one and only, my brother, Declan Nolan.
Hey Bears!
So Declan, why don't you tell the Bears what you've been up to since you graduated?
Well, I've been attending Montana State University studying film and photography for my major.
Wow, that's super exciting. You know what else is exciting?
What else is exciting?
Supporting local businesses. Let's go hear what Nick has to say about that.
Good morning and welcome back, Bears, to a live news report here from the Greater Maple Valley area. I, Nicholas Hall, went around and asked a bunch of your favorite places what they're doing to ensure your safety during this time of crisis. For starters, fast food places like McDonald's and Burger King, they are not doing any walk-ins. It is drive-through only, and they are not having you touch anything. They will hand you the credit card reader and you put your card in, no contact. Next, pizza places like Papa John's, Pizza Hut, Papa Murphy's, all those places, also takeout only, and they are also pursuing a new delivery method called no contact delivery. Basically, it's exactly what it sounds like. There is no contact between you and the delivery driver, and it is all safe. When they come back, they sanitize everything. Everything is sanitized and clean. Next, Safeway and Fred Meyer. They're limiting the amount of customers that can come into their lobby, into their store at a time. They're also sanitizing every station every couple of minutes to ensure that everything is clean and that there are no germs or bacteria or anything hanging around. And lastly, places like Hops and Drops and Pancake House are also doing takeout only. There is no dine-in. Everything is sanitized. Everything is clean. Bears, just remember this. Everybody here wants to stay in business, and so they are ensuring that they are doing the best that they can to make sure that their stores are clean and that the food they give you is healthy. Also, Bears, I was able to get one really important piece of information for all you Starbucks fans out there. So all Starbuckses in the Greater Maple Valley area will be closed until further notice. Right now, further notice is May 4th. So all Starbuckses in the Greater Maple Valley area will be closed until May 4th. This excludes the Starbucks inside Safeway and Fred Meyer. Those two are still open. But the other two Starbuckses are closed until further notice. That's all I have for you this week, Bears. I hope you enjoyed this nice little live news report of all your favorite food places. Now, let's throw it back to you guys.
Thanks for that awesome piece, Nick. Now, with all these changes going around, there's one thing that hasn't changed, and that's ASB elections. Get excited, Bears, because we get to see our current ASB president talk about what elections are looking like for next fall. So let's hear it, Nina.
Hi Bears, my name is Nina Channa, your ASB president, and I hope you guys are all staying safe during this crazy time. We just wanted to fill you in on a few things that we have going on right now. So campaigning for ASB elections is happening this week. So Bears, please follow the THS activities page on Instagram and your corresponding class Instagram pages for more information. And since elections and voting will be taking place next week, go ahead and keep up to date with your school emails for more information on voting. Have a good day, Bears.
Thanks for that information, Nina. I'm so excited to vote for my ASB officers for next fall. Well, Bears, that's all we got for this week. Continue to stay positive throughout this hard time and don't be afraid to reach out to your teachers and classmates because they do care. Thanks for tuning in and we'll see you next week. Bye.